A stroke is essentially disruption of blood flow to the brain, and the majority of the time it's caused by a clot blocking one of the blood vessels. Less commonly, it can actually be caused from bleeding within the brain that does the same thing. And so that tissue within the brain doesn't get adequate oxygen supply and starts to die, and that's essentially what a stroke is. The signs and symptoms of a stroke are varied. Most commonly, we'll see people develop either weakness or numbness on one side of the body or the other. Some people will also have difficulty either speaking or understanding speech, as well as can have trouble with swallowing. Difficulty with walking can also be a sign of a stroke, and those are some of the more common presentations of a stroke. The first thing to do if you think either you or a loved one has had a stroke is to call 911. Getting somebody to medical care as fast as possible is really important as far as the treatment or management of stroke is concerned. So that's the most important thing. The mnemonic FAST, as far as stroke is concerned, is helpful to remember some of the signs and symptoms and what you should do in a stroke. The F stands for face, so you're looking for any differences in the face, whether it's drooping on one side of the face versus the other. The next one, the A, stands for arm. So again, you can have weakness or numbness in one arm versus the other. S is for speech, and so slurred speech is definitely can be a sign of stroke. And then time, because time is really important as far as stroke is concerned. So if people see any of those signs, we want them to call 911 and try and get to the hospital as quickly as possible. As far as stroke treatment is concerned, there are a small percentage who will be a candidate for this clot-busting medication, which can essentially reverse the effects of a stroke immediately. For other people, we look at other causes for strokes. Sometimes blockages or narrowing of the arteries that feed the brain can contribute to strokes as well. So certain surgical procedures or stenting can be appropriate for certain people to help treat their stroke. We also want to make sure and manage their risk factors for stroke, which mean controlling blood pressure, cholesterol, and some of the other lifestyle issues that can go to contribute to strokes as well. Some of the things that a person can do to help try and lower their risk of having a stroke are making sure that things like blood pressure and cholesterol are managed appropriately, that living a healthy lifestyle, exercise and diet are obviously important, as well as things as simple as aspirin can really be beneficial in helping prevent a stroke.